Let's talk about alkylation of aldehydes and ketones via an enamine intermediate. And so the advantage is we avoid the use of harsh LDA conditions. A pKa of about 35 makes it a very damaging reagent to a lot of compounds that are base sensitive. It also is pyrophoric when you're making it and using it, and so it can catch fire for the poor grad student who's having to perform the reaction. So we can use an enamine and avoid these conditions, and also get a reagent that prefers a 1,4 Michael type addition. And so we would end up with this Michael acceptor here. We would add to the 1,4 position rather than the 1,2 because it's a softer nucleophile, and it's also a bulkier nucleophile, so it will go to the more accessible position there. And if we are using an unsymmetrical ketone, I've drawn a symmetrical ketone here, but if we're using an unsymmetrical, we will prefer the more thermodynamic enamine if that situation arises for the chelating reagent. So let's look at the full mechanism here. And so there's a little bit of bookkeeping to do by activating electrophiles throughout, and so we have to be very careful to show all mechanistic movement. And the first step, even though the proton is bouncing around on solvent, it likes to be on the pyrrolidine amine because it's slightly basic, but enough of the time, a lone pair on the ketone can grab that proton and we activate our electrophile. So protonate, now we're activated. This point, we can use pyrrolidine, our secondary amine, that can then attack that position and kick up the pi bond to a lone pair. When we do this, we form a tetrahedral intermediate like we're used to seeing. And we have to remember that we have a proton that we have to move around, and nitrogen gets a +1 formal charge. We can move this proton using a water. Lone pair back on the nitrogen. And then we have this species. Now, we've regenerated our acid, so to speak, and we need to make this OH into a good leaving group. And so we do that by protonating it and forming a water leaving group that we will redraw here. And the lone pair on nitrogen can now come back down. Oops, got to show that OH2. There's our water leaving group, and then kick off that leaving group. And we have formed, at this point, an iminium species. And so this species prefers its enamine form. So we can take a solvent molecule and essentially tautomerize here this iminium into our key intermediate, the enamine. So at this point, we can add our alkylation reagent. So we'll say ethyl bromide here. An alkyl group works, an acyl halide, a Michael acceptor, any one of those things can work. Lone pair comes down, forms the pi bond, opens up the enamine, and we alkylate our compound, reforming an iminium species. Add two carbons, 1,2, there we go. And so at this point, a little bit of aqueous acid in solution can then take our formally charged +1, our activated electrophile. The water then adds to that carbon, kicks up the pi bond to a lone pair. We've got another tetrahedral intermediate. And the path that leads forward deprotonates water. Reprotonates our pyrrolidine group here in an acid-base reaction, so I'll show that right here. Now we've got a good leaving group in pyrrolidine, so that when the oxygen lone pair reforms a pi bond, it can kick off a good leaving group in pyrrolidine from this species here. And we're one step away, a simple acid-base transfer, proton transfer, and we've got our alkylated ketone. And we're